Hello, so the game does a very poor job at explaining to you what it is and what you have to do, so let's go over some of the basic things. I'll not play a game, I'll just speak about the character creation, loadouts and other stuff, but first of all you have to understand a few things. You can play the game without paying any money for it, but it's kind of recommended you at least do the season pass to a high level because you'll start to get better things after that. So you can view the season pass as your account level, your account progression. Is not going to be just cosmetics because you'll get chances to bet, chances to get gear, skills, and other stuff. So let's kind of make a short guide over here as well. So equipment, which can be of various quality. Of course, the highest quality will have 4 skills, which might have bigger or higher levels than your basic one. So basic one might have, let's say, 1 or 2 skills, but it'll be level 1 or 2. While one of the better ones, I guess I can show you, will have much more than that. So as you can see, it's 4 skills and some of them are level 3. So as you can see, those are mostly level 1 and 2. And this can be also level 3 epic ones, or prestige as they're called over here. And this is mythic. So yeah, that's what they mean by that. So more chances to get more items with still the RNG factor in them, but it's going to be much better. But you also get some interesting stuff. You also get more money and also boosters. So it's worth doing the season pass the best you can. And for that, you just need to do your basic quests. And after that, you'll get the daily and the weekly quests, which I recommend you do very, very often. Because, for example, if I go to level 6, I'll get 3000 coins. And with those coins I can buy something from the shop, which you can also get just by playing the game normally, but it's much easier to just buy them, right? So the scrolls, as you can see, this will make me have the rush down to level 2. Collect more of this to unlock higher levels of the rush down. You still need to level up the skill itself. Whirlwind. That's a mythic skill. And you can also buy gear and also a lot of other stuff. But you can also use those 3000 to get boosters, experience, or better items, or more items. More items, better items. And also change some things. Again, I'm not going into this because it's a lot of things we have to say. Also, you might... I don't recommend you buy the contract ones because they're very, very strong, but they are limited, so you can only use them 3 times. And sometimes you'll buy one of these and someone knocks you off a cliff and you die and lose the character. Super strong, but not worth it in my opinion, because you also will need to level up your characters. So that's for the progression. Now let's go to the characters themselves. Now I don't want to waste a lot of time, so I'll just say that usually you will have to mix and match them, but here you create your characters and here in your decks you add your characters. I recommend you play with 3 warriors in the beginning, and as they level up you'll get the chance to give them better gear and better titles. The title is an interesting mechanic because it allows you to give them better gear but also increases the cooldown in which you can use them. So I recommend you have 1 knight, 1 squire and 1 simple one. So as you can see, no title, first title, second title. So this will have 500 CP or combat points, this will have 400, this will have 250, but this guy is on no cooldown. Don't ever play a game where you have characters that can be on cooldown, because that means if you die too fast you will not be able to play the game. So my opinion, you should have 3 warriors in the beginning to kind of see how the game is and kind of grow accustomed to the game. Now your basic character will have no cooldown, so that means it will be kind of hard to play with him because it will be very weak. But what are the best items to give them? And you might wonder, why 3 knights, 3 warriors? Because they're much easier to play with and they're useful in any situation. Attack, defense and utility, or just flanking and other stuff. The cleric at level 1 or the mage at level 1, they're very weak. So you'll have to play a very, very gimmicky way with them until you can upgrade them. So as you can see, I've upgraded my cleric. But let's get back to the warrior. So his weapons will be the basic ones that have the lowest CP coin, CP cost, and then I just give him the power bomb level 2. I think there's not much of a difference between level 1 or 2, but I just like this one, level 2, the power bomb, because it might mean the difference between killing someone and letting them live. 140 HP for a basic mage, but 320 for an upgraded sister or cleric. So yeah, 300 380, 500. So you can see there's a bit of a difference between them as well. So that's why I prefer this one, because it basically does a lot more damage and you can finish off an opponent with attacks after that. And here you can just put whatever you want, but usually it will be Rocket or Whirlwind or Rushdown. Super useful. And this is the part of the game that I find you don't get a lot of explanations. All of your warriors need to have a very, very good ranged weapon. Now, it's kind of a different situation because they don't explain this, so this will be more for demolition, while the other ones will be more for damage. The revolver cannons are trashed here. The burst crossbows are kind of useful, more or less, but it mostly depends on how much ammo they have, so as you can see, it's not a lot of ammo. So the best ones will be the hunting crossbows, and then the assault crossbows, then the burst, and then the revolver last. The hunting crossbow is kind of like, you imagine that it's a rifle. So equip all of your warriors with these things, they'll be super good for you. And here it can be barrier or anything else, but always have cover shot on them. Because this allows you to set up a kind of a shield in front of you, and you can shoot more ammunition, more bolts at the enemy. Does it say over here? Well, it doesn't say, but I think it's almost double the amount of shots you normally have. And over here, I recommend you have these ones in the beginning. Well, that is if you get them. Building speed 40%, building accuracy level 2, and then tower occupation, or whatever else you want, or whatever else you have the points for. So that's your basic one. So what does the square have different? Well, as you can see, still the same thing, because you can get a lot of points, experience points, and also upgrade points for your classes. So you need to a certain amount of points before you can summon the squire, and then you need a certain amount of points before you can summon the knight. So you need to have a good performance in the game by building stuff, or by killing enemies, or by doing objectives, or your role, your team role in that game, so you can use the more powerful classes. As you can see, well, the armors also have skills on them, so that will be 10 HP with 10 HP. So as you can see, he has a bit more HP because of his gear. Also, the skills are more or less the same, so the Scour will be more like an attack class with a better weapon. It's not much better than the normal one, if you look at it, 42, 28, but has object damage, critical damage, and sword attack. So that means all of your attacks will be a little more powerful. And he also has the Whirlwind, because I don't know, I feel like he's going to be in combat a lot of times, and he'll also be kind of charging and attacking the mage lines. If you manage to get past the warriors, you will attack the mages or the clerics super good. Again, hunting crossbow and cover shot. This is the same thing as always. And over here we'll have the basic equipment, basically the best I can put on him, but as you can see, I still maxed it out very fast. Cleric Killer, Siege Weapon, Attack Up, Flag Bearer Speed. I just wanted to have something very good on him. So as you can see, it's a lot of other things. You can change the... I don't like this, because you can change the perk with this one, and that means... Well, again, I'll not get into it. But you can do that. Barrage is also the one I use most of all, because you can use that with other people, and you can throw barrage with more people, and that will destroy the gates pretty fast. So as you can see, he has a little better sword, power bomb, and whirlwind. I think I will replace this with Rocket. As whirlwind doesn't do enough damage in my opinion, so let's replace this with a level 2 Rocket as well. And over here, he has a much better hunting crossbow, so I guess you should always give him more HP and a much better hunting crossbow. And then it's basically more or less the same thing, except I wanted him to have a little more health. Speed up seems like he's not a very good skill at level 1. So after you play with your free warriors a lot of times, and after you do your basic quests, and you start having to do the season, or the daily quests, and the weekly quests. And this can be playing a mage, playing a cleric, and so on, so then you might want to create your other characters. Let me show you how my basic mage is right now, because like I said, if you play the game a lot of times, usually you'll get items for the other classes, which is a bit weird, but that's how the game is. I got a lot of cleric and a lot of mage items just by playing my warriors. And after that, I started getting items for all of the classes, including them. So basic, You can replace this one, but this is a massive boost to your CPU, which is not good because it means it costs a lot. But I also have this one, which as you can see, it's 14 seconds cooldown compared to 18. Weapon skills, try to have an upgraded basic weapon and then lightning and rocket punch. Super useful, very useful. As you can see, it's a lot of damage and there'll be a lot of fun to use in combat as well. So these are basically your heavy hitters. And over here we have the fireball. I guess I can replace the fireball with other stuff. Ice spear would be a good option over here, but I don't have enough points. Alternatively, you can replace the magic arrow with other stuff as well, but magic arrow is super useful because this one has capacity for me. 50% ammo, 25% ammo, so that's enough to kill, I think, almost any class in the battlefield if you get all hits. And I wish this would be ice spear, but again, it's not going to be worth it to replace other stuff. I might consider it again. And crows and flash step, so teleport, crowd control for the enemy, and fireball. I'll see what I can do to replace that with a basic ice spear. Because I don't have talents on this one either, so we'll mostly be using the main ones. So again, ice spear, and then the crows, and then the flash step. So that's basically what you need to do for a basic mage. Now the cleric. Well, the cleric, I gave her a lot of armor, so she has a lot of HP. Mage killer HP. The war in... not very useful in my opinion, but it can be fun to use. I'm not sure how this works, because sometimes if you press the button, you'll get two armor things, and that will be 50 armor, which will be added on top of your HP. So I think that will be about, what, 370 HP or something like that. And it's kind of recommended use your basic weapons, even though I have much better ones. And these ones actually have a lot more damage, so that's what, 30% more damage. More demolition as well. But I like the area heal. Instead of the normal heal, use the area heal over here and the holy protection over here. Well, 20 armor for your allies. Oh no, this gives me the additional armor, so I guess this also will give you armor. And this will also give you armor, so that's why I like it. Now I remember. This froze the item on the ground, and that's a skill that everyone can join in. Secondly, over here, I give her an assault crossbow. Now, to be honest, I only give her an assault crossbow because I don't have another hunting crossbow, so I'm a bit sad about that. But this actually works much better on her because she's supposed to be a mage killer. So switch to your first weapon, put down an area heal, then switch to your ranged weapon. With the assault crossbow, you can kill the pesky mages, so she's a mage killer. Area of, again, just put this down near a mage and then pull out your assault crossbow and shoot them. Now, if I think again, I think I would have preferred other things, but this is basically the most you can get because I have damage up, level 2, and capacity level 3, 75% more ammo. So assault crossbow would load capacity on the cleric if you can. Otherwise, I don't think anything else will be better, because, yeah. The burst one seems kind of the same, but it's kind of hard to aim the burst one, so I don't really recommend it. So assault, and the wall, just in case you need to have a little bit of cover when you heal, when you do something. The accelerator is also super useful, so this is how a lot of speed up, HP up. Again, I didn't have a lot of choices over here, so I just pick a little more HP and a little speed, and also build speed. You're supposed to play this a certain way. For example, you are alone on the field, use accelerator, you go to the fighting position, you use area heal and maybe protection and maybe some other stuff, and then you just use your crossbow and sometimes you'll put down your wall, and then you'll sometimes attack them, but again, it's a self-healing character, so sorry if I was a little bit confusing on the cleric, but this is how I think he should be played. As a mage killer, as a support unit, as a fast intervention unit, and kind of like all around good for everything, but not good at anything specific. While the warriors are basically ranged specialists to help with sieges, push the ram and do other stuff, and the mages are basically clowns. Clowns in a clown world. Now you also have, as you can see, you get some free samples of the better characters, not the strongest. And the way you use them is you just put them in your deck and then you summon them if you have enough points. But to be honest, the skills are very bad. Lunge Slash and... although it's a level 5 Lunge Slash, so it's super powerful and this has a big range because it's level 5 as well. I don't think they're as useful as you might think. Lightning, Windtrap, Familiar Shooter. Yeah, I think the mage is probably the best out of them. Because he actually has the utility skills as well. So this is a very good build for a mage. Plus, he has 280 HP. Compared to 140, which is the basic one. So that's basically double HP. So, I guess that's enough. Bye.